Hello friends, welcome to the MindTouchTech YouTube channel. My name is Prince and this is our 27th JavaScript lecture. And in this lecture, we will study about that, how to hide a div tag by clicking on a particular button and also how to display that div tag again by clicking on the same button, friends. This is very good and very important topic of the JavaScript. In our previous lecture, we have studied about the document.getElementById and also event listener, friends. And this topic also will be covered in that lecture, friends. So let us start, friends. So friends, first of all, what I have to make, a button. By clicking on that button, our div tag will be hide. And also by clicking on that button again, our div tag will be displayed to us, friends. So we have to create a button. So to create a button, we have to write here the input type is equals to button. And after that, we have to give the value to the button. That is, the value is equals to suppose click me. Click me is the value of that button, friends. And after that, we have to give the ID to that button. That is, the ID is equals to suppose my button. That is, the my BTN is the ID of that button, friends. So I have created that button. Now Control plus S and open that file here. Now you can see here a button has been created, that is the click me, friends. Okay, now what I want, friends, by clicking on that button, the div tag that I will make will be hide, and also by clicking on that button again, the div tag will be again visible to us, friends. So let us see, this is important, friends. So first of all, we have to make a div tag in HTML, friends. So let us make a div tag, friends. So to make a div tag, what you have to do, we have to write here the div tag and then the close of the div tag, friends. That's about it, friends. Now what I want, friends, I want to apply the styling to that div tag, friends. So I have to give here the ID of that div tag so that it will be accessible to us. So ID is equals to suppose my div. My div is the ID of the div tag, friends. Now let us apply the styling to that div tag by the use of the CSS, friends. So we have to do here like that, and we have to write here in the head section, that is the style tag and then the close of the style tag, friends. Now between that style tag, what I want to apply the styling to that div tag, so I have to access the ID of that div tag, that is the my div, friends. So I have to write here the hashtag and then the name of the ID, that is the my div, friends. And after that, I have to apply here the styling. Suppose I want the width of the div tag, that is, should be 100%, and height of the div tag should be like 57 pixel, friends. Okay, now Control plus S. Now this div tag will not be visible to us. Control plus R, and you can see here that div tag is existing here, but it is not visible to us. Why it is not visible to us? Because we didn't give any background color to that div tag. So we have to give here the background color of that div tag so that it will be visible to us. Let us give the background color, that is the blue, friends. Control plus S, Control plus R. You can see here that a div tag has been shown here, and whose width is 100% and the height is 57 pixel, friends. Okay, now let us give the margin from the top so that it will look good. So let us give the margin, that is, the margin from the top is suppose 23 pixel, friends. That's about it, friends. Control plus S, Control plus R. You can see that it is looking good now, friends. Now our main concept will be started, friends. What I want, friends, when I click on that button, then this div tag should be hide, friends, should be hidden, friends. Okay, when I again click on that div tag, then this will again display, friends. That is, by clicking on that, this will be hide, and by clicking on that again, this will again display to us, friends. Let us see how. This is important, friends. So first of all, what we have to do, we have styled that, forget about that, friends. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to use the JavaScript here, friends. So again, I have to write here the script tag and then the close of the script tag, friends. That's about it, friends. Now what is our first step? Our first step is to access that ID that is named my button in the JavaScript, because we want to apply the onClick event to that button, friends. So first of all, I have to access the button ID, that is the button, that is the my button, friends. This is about that. So to access that ID, I again have to write here the document.getElementById. Get element by ID, and after that, in a double quotes, I have to give the name of the ID that I want to access. So I want to access the my button named ID, that is this type of ID. So I have to give here the name of the ID, that is the my button, friends. This is about that, friends. And after that, I have to apply here the event listener to that. Okay, so I have to write here the dot and then the add event listener. add event listener that I have already discussed about in my previous lecture friends. Okay, if you don't have the knowledge of that, then you can visit my previous lecture friends. That is the add event listener, and after that the braces of that, and in these braces two parameters will be passed. The first parameter is the event that you want to apply, and the second is the function, or that is the action that you want to apply by clicking on that. So first I have to write here the name of the event, that is suppose I want to apply the onClick event, so I have to write here the click event, the JavaScript. And after that again comma, and after that suppose make a function here, that is a function, and the braces of the function. You can also make that function externally friend. And after that the curly braces of the function. Now in the curly braces of the function our main concept will be started friends. Okay, now by clicking on that button our div tag must be in the hidden form friends. So you have to give here the, we first have to access the div tag, that is the ID of the div tag, that is the my div friend. Okay, so you have to write here again the document dot get element by ID, and in that braces I have to write here the name of the div tag ID, that is the my div friend. You can see here friends. So I have accessed that div tag here in the JavaScript friends. That's what it is. And then semicolon. Now let us put that div tag in a variable friends. So let us assign here the variable name, that is the variable suppose my box is equals to that part. My box friends. This is about that. So I have assigned the variable in that. So now my box named variable is our div tag friends. Okay. So let us do after that what you have to do, focus on that, what I'm going to do, tell you about focus on that. So first of all what you have to do, we have to apply the condition here first, but that condition will be like that, when we click on that button the div tag must be in the hidden form first. Okay, so you know that, you know that the two properties of the CSS like display block or display none. Okay, you know, I think you remember that the display is none means that is the div tag or any tag, any element is hidden. But if you write here the display block, it means that elements or the any tag div tag is visible to us. So we will apply that display block property or the display none property here in the JavaScript friends. Okay, so again we have to write here, after that we have to apply here the condition, that is the if condition. If our my box means our div tag, if our my box dot style dot display, I will tell you the working of that friends, don't be confused on that. I will explain you about that what I'm going to do here friends. Okay, so we have to write here the my box, that is the name of the variable, that is this is the div tag. If div tag display is equals to, and it means equals to is equals to none friends. Okay, means the div tag is if hidden, then what should print here, then my box dot style dot display, that is should be equals to block. That's what it friends. So what I did here friends, are you confused in that? So what I did friends, first of all I accessed that my box named ID, that is this is the div tag. If the div tag display, that is if the div tag is hidden, that is the none, then the div tag by clicking on the button, then the div tag must be displayed to us. Okay, else we have to write here the else, and after that again I have to write here the my box dot style dot display is equals to what, is equals to none friends. That's what it friends. I will tell you the working of that, don't be confused on that. First of all control plus S friends, and then now control plus R friends. Now if you click on that, now you can see that the div tag is now in hidden form. Now if you again click on that, now you can see that the div tag is now visible to us. Click on hidden, click again back, it is visible to us friends. How are you doing friends? So first of all let us see, focus on that friends. So first of all what I did here friends, I have created a div tag and have put the properties in that div tag. Okay, I hope that you know about that. Our main concept is the CSS. First of all what I did here friends, I have accessed that button, that is the named my button in the JavaScript friends. And after that I have applied here the add event listener friends, and in that I have applied here the event named click. Okay, and after that by clicking on that a function must be called, and in that function our div tag coding is here friends. Okay, when we click on that, when we click on the button, then this function will be execute friends, and in that function our div tag coding is here. Okay, so we, in that function we have to first access the div tag, that is the document.getElementById, and the name of the ID of the div tag, that is the my div tag. So I have accessed my that div tag here in the JavaScript frame. Okay. Okay, and also what I did here, friends, I have assigned a variable to that div tag, to that div tag. It means that my box is now our div tag, friends. So now we will apply the properties to that my box, that is the div tag, friends. So we apply the condition if my box dot style dot display. This style is for the CSS property, that is the in the CSS property there is a property also display, friends. In the CSS there is a property display, friends. So we have applied here the style tag, friends. It will access the display property, friends. So if the div tag display is none, means if the display, if the div tag is hidden form by clicking on that, then it should display by clicking on that, that is the block, friend. That div tag must be visible to us, that is by clicking on that. If it is hidden, then by clicking on that it will be visible. And if here you can see that else my box dot style dot display is equals to none, friends. This is about that, friends. Okay, if that is none, then it's by clicking on that it will be visible to us, it will be blocked to us. If that is not, it is, if that is blocked, then it should be not visible to our friends. So that's about it, friends. Now control plus R again, click on that hidden, click on that again, visible to us, friends. So this is the concept of the hide and display again of the div tag, friends. So thank you. So friends, in this lecture we have studied about that, how to hide a div tag by clicking on a particular button, and also how to display that div tag again. I hope you have understood that. If you have any doubt, then you can comment me, friends. And if you like my video, then you can subscribe my channel, share my friend, and also press the bell icon for the latest notifications. So thank you, take care, bye bye.